Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. My name is Dr. Wan from International Islamic University Malaysia. In this video, I would like to share about one of our group research project that involves chitin. This is a filter paper made up from cellulose, and this is a paper made up from the chitin. At the molecular level, both look similar, but chitin has an extra acetamidyl group. Having this group not only encourages more hydrogen bonding, which gives chitin stronger mechanical properties, but it also makes chitin hydrophobic. When something is hydrophobic, it blends well with other hydrophobic material like common plastic. That is why chitin has the potential to reinforce this PLA filament, the most commonly used plastic in 3D printing, to create a truly green and strong composite material. While chitin is typically extracted from this crab shell, our current project focuses on extracting chitin from fungi, namely from the mushroom. We extract chitin from the oyster mushroom, from the shiitake mushroom, and also from the enoki mushroom. For the extraction process, we begin by thawing a frozen mushroom, blending them in the kitchen blender and using hot water extraction to remove the soluble material. We then treat the remaining material with alkali to remove residual proteins. Finally, we neutralize the extract with an excess water and store it in a wet condition. We then use this chitin extract to create a nanopaper through simple vacuum filtration process and drying. After the testing, we found that the enoki chitin produced the strongest paper, oyster chitin make the toughest paper, while the shiitake chitin was in somewhere in between. Since PLA is naturally brittle, like this 3D printing filament made from PLA, you can just break it and it snaps just like that, we choose oyster mushroom chitin to reinforce it. We make our composite 3D printing filament by mixing PLA with our chitin extract. And at certain percentage, we observe clear reinforcement compared to PLA-only filament. However, buying a mushroom like this from the supermarket and to use it for this project presents a challenge. It competes with food security. So, we start extracting chitin from the mycelium of the mushroom instead. We found that the properties of the mycelium's chitins were even better. Moving forwards, we are now exploring ways of producing mushroom and also mycelium in-house, ensuring stable supply of raw material for chitin extraction for future applications.